tanár úrról mindenki tudja, hogy szinte a fél életét az ifjúság zenei nevelésére szánta. És tanár úr szerint mikor kell kezdeni az iskolai zenei nevelést?
Hát bizony még az iskola előtt kellene, az óvodában. Általános tapasztalat, hogy a zenei iskolákban sokkal könnyebben és barátságosabban megy mindez, és az együttes éneklés fényelemre és felelősségérzetre szoktatja őket. Tehát ennyiben jellemképző ereje is van.
Olyan ember életművéről beszélünk, aki a magyar és egyetemes zenekultúra egyik géniusza, egy különleges, alkotó, kreatív ember, akit igazából szívén viselte az, hogy mi lesz ennek az országnak a jövője.
Kodályban minden benne van. Ha zenét fognak tanítani az emberiség történetében, a Kodály gondolatok, a Kodály elvek örökérvényűek.
Kodály-concept, the absolute basic thing that I would use every day in my work is the concept of active music making. So not talking about music, but doing it.
Thank you for Zoltán Kodály. He's a genius. He understood how to teach music to children. It's just amazing. It's amazing.
Kodály Zoltán zenepedagógiai koncepciója és a tanítványai által kidolgozott tanítási módszerek eredményei hatalmas érdeklődést váltottak ki a világban. Számtalan országból érkeztek tanárok Magyarországra azzal a céllal, hogy a módszert szülőhelyén tanulmányozzák. Képzésük irányítója Szőnyi Erzsébet, a Zeneakadémia tanszékvezető tanára volt. Ajánlására számos fiatal magyar énekzenetanár és karvezető kezdett el rendszeresen külföldön tanítani.
A Zeneakadémián töltöttem 5 évet. Mi ezt a kifejezést, hogy Kodály módszer, soha nem hallottuk. Tehát én is akkor találkoztam először ezzel a kifejezéssel, amikor elkezdtem egy zenei általános iskolában tanítani, és nagyon hamar jöttek a különböző külföldi vendégek és csoportok, és ők mondogatták, hogy Kodály módszer. És akkor mi csodálkoztunk, hogy Kodály módszer. Hát mi nekünk ez olyan természetes volt, anélkül, hogy ez meg lett volna címkézve.
Egy alkalom voltam, hogy japán, valaki megkérdezte tőlem, hogy tulajdonképpen mi az, hogy Kodály módszer? Hát én így nem fogalmaztam ezt soha meg, csak csináltam ösztönösen ezeket az elemeket és ezeket a dolgokat, természetesen a zenéből kiindul. És akkor valahogy tudom, hogy olyan nagyon összeszedtem magam, és akkor döbbentem rá, hogy tulajdonképpen micsoda kincs és érték van a kezünkben.
Szőnyi tanárnő volt a tanszékvezető, és megkért bennünket, hogy 5 mondatba foglaljuk össze a Kodály koncepció lényegét. És mindenki mást írt. Egészen mást. És ez olyan megdöbbentő volt valahogy, hogy ez, hogy lehet, hogy ez nem ilyen egyértelmű. És azt hiszem, ennek a legnagyobb értéke pontosan ebben van, hogy nem elég, nem tudom, 10 tételt követni, és akkor megvan a Kodály koncepció.
The Kodály philosophy, Kodály's vision presents the language of music, the concept of sound. Music is a language containing the characteristics of sound.
Kodály felismerte, hogy a művészi nevelés, a művészetekkel való korai találkozás kihatással van az ember személyiségének fejlődésére.
Ez egy szemléletmód, egy élet tulajdonképpen, ami az ember egészét neveli. Az éneklésen keresztül, de egy teljes személyiséget formálva.
The work of Kodály and this philosophical point of view reminds us that actually we are very deeply human and that our experiences are what are so important, that guide and shape our lives. And the music, these cultural artifacts, are things which remind us who we specifically are. So the folk songs of Hungary, the folk songs of Canada or of Scotland or of Australia, these are ways of reminding us about who we are as people and as cultures.
Kodály halála után 3 évvel, 1970-ben Kodály Zoltánné Péceli Sarolta kezdeményezésére rendezték meg Kecskeméten az első nemzetközi Kodály szemináriumot. Az álom, hogy a kodályi zenepedagógiának legyen egy önálló intézménye, 1975-ben vált valóra, amikor Erdei Péter vezetésével a külföldi érdeklődők számára megnyílt a Kodály intézet. Az azóta a Zeneakadémia részévé vált intézet a legfontosabb zarándokhelye Kodály pedagógiai örökségének.
A kezdetekben elsősorban magyar zenepedagógusok vezették a szemináriumi munkát, ugyanakkor az utóbbi években úgy éreztem, hogy mindaz, ami a nemzetközi szintéren történt az elmúlt évtizedekben, Kodály zenepedagógiához kapcsolódóan, mindazok a kiváló zenepedagógusok, akik valaha itt tanultak és hazamentek, és az ő ismereteiket adaptálni tudták, a saját környezetükben újra gondolni, mindaz a tapasztalat, ami az elmúlt évtizedekben ebben a témában felhalmozódott, én ezt szerettem volna visszacsatolni ide.
It's always fantastic to come here, and the work that we do with the classes is always so exciting. We have people from all over the world in my class. I had Italians, of course, we had some Italians, even some British people, some Australian people, some Chinese people, and it's this fabulous mix of people. And that's what makes this international feeling of the Kodály movement, that everyone from all around the world can come, work together and learn together. I always really enjoy teaching here. It's fantastic. And I think, Lucy, you feel like that too,
absolutely,
don't you?
Absolutely the same, yeah. My class was the same. Truly international feel. And I've loved working with this group from Beijing because it makes me see my own teaching through different eyes and challenges but joys.
Actually, in every country, it's really important from our perspective that we try and work out what's happening in that country and then try and work out what can we do to help them. And I think that's why people like us who do a lot of teaching around, we need to do that work because we can rely on what we've done before, rely on our experiences and try and help in whichever
country
we're in.
I think for you and I, we've already taken this model that's Hungarian and adapted in our own country. So therefore it's maybe easier to advise other people how they might adapt. because we've already been through that process.
And then when I go to a new country, my first statement is, well, you will have to work out how this works in your country, yes? So I think this idea of teaching all around the world, one of the values of the Kodály idea is that it's this philosophy rather than a strict rigid set of rules. Mm. It's ideas, and we have to try and help people understand in their school, with their governments, with their teacher requirements, exactly how we can try and help.
When we say Kodály method, it's not just the philosophy, but the work of all those people who implemented Kodály's ideas into practice. And I think without them, without these great musicians who really knew what to do in the schools, we wouldn't be anywhere.
And this is the point I'm making. I think here in Hungary, you've been doing it for so long, so many good people have thought about it and refined it and developed it, and that's still going on, that the younger generation are still learning and changing because the society is changing.
Nagyon fontosnak gondolom, hogy arra neveljem rá a gyerekeket és a fiatal kollégákat, hogy a saját maguk személyiségével vegyék birtokba a zenét, ne utánozzanak, ne egy modellt vegyenek át, hanem természetesen egy ügyesen irányított módon maguk fedezzenek fel minden apróságot, és a bennük lévő zenét teljesítsék ki. És erre a Kodály filozófia megalapozza azt a fajta módszertani repertoárt és eszközrendszert, amivel sikeresen lehet eljutni bármilyen szintig.
The Kodály Institute provides a safe environment for everybody. It's okay if this is your strength and this is your weakness. Everybody somehow comes together to help one another. This was a new experience for me, in that everybody wants everybody else to succeed.
You get a lot of useful tools about everything. I felt that somehow I had a package that in whatever musical situation I may be, as a maybe teacher, of course, but also sometimes as performer, I could use some tools. If I need to sing, I can pick up that from my package. If I need to play the piano, I can pick up that from my package. If I need to analyze something, I can pick that other one.
Edinburgh-ban vagyunk, a skót nemzeti ifjúsági kórus a NICOS által rendezett nyári Kodály kurzuson. A NICOS Skócia egyik legfontosabb ifjúsági szervezete, amely kórusain és oktatási programjain keresztül több mint egy évtizede gyakorol nagy hatást a skóciai kórus kultúrára. Képzéseik teljes egészében a Kodály módszer gyakorlatára épülnek.
One of the biggest challenges in adopting a Kodály-inspired program that I had then seen in Hungary, in action in Hungary, was how to make it applicable to our situation in Scotland. And the games, for me, are a hugely important part, not only because they subconsciously catch musical concepts, their clapping rhythms, their feeling rhythms, so it becomes part of them, but just the joy of play. When I was at school, we had to sit tall, sit straight, sit still, sing. And I absolutely didn't see that that was the way I wanted music education to be for the children I taught. I wanted them to experience the joy of movement. But I think it's not just the joy, it's a deeper understanding and a deeper learning if they're engaged. And actually, the games are quite complex. Children are never too old to play games, and that's been something that has really featured quite strongly in my mind, that older children still want to be playing games.
Yeah. If I was to sum up what NICOS' mission statement is, it's to get Scotland's young people singing, and also, not just the voice, training the brain through the work that we do based on the work of Zoltán Kodály. The beauty of Kodály's approach is, of course, it really is singing-based. It starts with the voice. So there couldn't be a better method to help train the musicianship of our young singers. Once the various different aspects of the music are in the child's mind, a good teacher can extract the concepts, can make alive the elements of pitch and of rhythm and of intonation, which informs the greater musician. I would say this can be done anywhere, where you have enthusiastic staff, capable staff, and talented young children.
Your onion glasses on, some don't. Okay? No pressure, but if you don't engage your eyes, the onion glasses are going on. One, two. You see? You see? $12.99. And there you are. Oh, I'm not wearing those things.
Over the last decade, I have run singing courses for amateurs up to the age of 85. My oldest person that I've taught is 85. And I think we need to look at the whole picture in singing. The youngsters are wonderful, and the young people that train as teachers and performers are wonderful. But so also are the generation that sometimes we forget about. For example, if they have to leave their choirs, having spent a lifetime singing, when their voices change because of their age, maybe sort of 50 plus, and then when people become lonely, and if they're not singing in a choir socially, it's very important to train them, not to train them, but to work with them so they re-find their voice and continue to enjoy singing right through till the day that they can't physically sing.
One, and two, you go. Sol, do, re, sol, do, re, mi, re, mi, sol, fa, la, sol, do. Shame, shame. We found that taking this Kodály philosophy and beginning with it with older beginners, and that could be in the high school, it could be children who are in the primary school but at the upper end of primary school. I also took those same ideas and worked with that approach at the university level. And so these were older students again, and I've done the same thing with adults. So I do feel that if we work hard to understand the deep ideas that Kodály has captured in his philosophy, that we can find ways to use this approach with older children as well.
Az edinburghi Kodály-kurzus programját néhány éve a Finnországban élő magyar hegedűművész Szilvai Géza által megalkotott színes húrok hegedű módszertani tanfolyam is gazdagítja.
Az, hogy a többi módszer az tulajdonképpen, hogyha hangszerrel beszélek, az a hangszert tartja középpontban. A Kodály módszernél az ember van a középpontban, és egy teljes embert alakít. Tehát nem csak a kezet, a technikát fejleszti, hanem az agyat fejleszti, a fület, a szívet, tehát az egész embert. Ugye, ahogy a Kodály mondta, hogy ez a négy nagyon fontos, hogy a fül legyen tiszta, a kéz legyen ügyes, az ész legyen a munkával benne, és a negyedik az, hogy az érzelem ott legyen. Tehát ez tulajdonképpen egyedülálló a világban. Pam, 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 pam,
pam, pam. No, no, yes, that is good. Yeah, pam. You see, it's working. Fingers, 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 fingers.
Maga a színes húrok tanítási mód, az tulajdonképpen a Kodály elveknek, a Kodály gondolatoknak, a Kodály filozófiának és módszernek a hegedűre és a csellóra való megvalósítása.
What I get from attending the Nykos Kodály summer schools is firstly access to some of the best teachers in the world. We have the best Kodály educators in Kodály methodology and musicianship that are available on the planet, really. This year, I think some of the special experiences that I've had are in the musicianship class, finally being able to understand a bit of harmony properly.
I was lucky enough to go to Kecskemet last summer and meet Laszlo and Lucinda when I was singing with a demonstration choir at the Kodály Summer School in Kecskemet, at the Kodály Institute. I was astonished by the potential of this philosophy of music education, and I thought, this is something that I want to do. So I signed up to come to the Nykos Summer School in Edinburgh. I've just had a wonderful week, and I've learned so much about how to teach, about how to break down concepts and principles into small units and build them up step by step, and I just can't wait to put it into practice.
Az amerikai Kodály tanárok országos szervezete 1975-ben alakult meg. Tagszervezetein keresztül segíti, hogy a kodályi szemlélet minél több iskolában jelen legyen. Évente rendeznek konferenciát több ezer zenetanár részvételével. A 2018-ast Oklahoma City-ben tartották. Minden konferencia a szervezet himnusza a Harmonia Mundi eléneklésével kezdődik. A magyar zeneoktatás iránti amerikai érdeklődés Kodály Zoltán három hónapos észak-amerikai körútjával kezdődött 1966-ban. Neves egyetemeken, többek között a Stanfordon tartott nagy hatású előadást a zenei nevelés fontosságáról.
Ma nem sokkal 12 óra előtt visszaérkezett az Amerikai Egyesült Államokból Kodály Zoltán háromszoros Kossuth-díjas zeneszerző. Milyen a visszhangja a magyar zenei életnek az amerikai kontinensen?
Az, hogy jönnek ide tanulni, 50 ezer dollárt osztanak ki 10 fiatal tanító közt, hogy ide jöjjenek megtanulni a mi módszerünket.
Milyen érdeklődést keltett a magyar zenei élet ezen a népzenei kongresszuson?
Nagyot, nagy érdeklődést. Mind az öt előadó nő nagy sikerrel szerepelt, és nagy érdeklődést keltett.
Az Egyesült Államokban szakmai fórumokon több elismert magyar zenepedagógus, Szőnyi Erzsébet, Forrai Katalin, Kokas Klára, Nemesszegi Lajosné és Szabó Helga tartott beszámolót a magyarországi modell pozitív tapasztalatairól. 1969-ben indult el a tanártovábbképzés. Két Kodály-központ, a keleti parton a Massachusetts-i Kodály Musical Training Institute, a nyugati parton az Oaklandi Holy Names University Kodály-központjának létrehozásával. A képzéseken számos fiatal magyar tanár oktatott, többek között Erdei Péter, Komlós Katalin, Rozgonyi Éva, Hegyi Erzsébet és Nemes Klára.
The Holy Names College program, as it was called at the beginning, was founded by Sister Mary Alice Hine in 1969. She had met Zoltán Kodály when he was at Stanford in 1966. And she was so enthralled by what she saw that she then went to Hungary to study there and came back and founded the program at this very tiny university in Oakland, California.
And Lasky, Gail Needleman, and others have worked towards collecting appropriate materials in the American context. Initially, the collection was 2,000 songs gathered by Eleanor Locke and Sister Mary Alice Hine. The collection has been recognized as an archive by the Library of Congress.
So what I loved about Holy Names is they had Hungarians every semester and every summer. And so in the fall I studied with Lenci Ego, and Ildikó was there in the spring semester, and Mrs. Hedgie was there for the summer times. And then the following year, even though I had graduated and was teaching in the Hayward School District, Gabi Tays was the choir director and Eva Vendre was the choir director. So I've had the opportunity to study with just amazing Hungarian master teachers.
I think that if we are successful here, it really has ramifications back to Hungary too. So the influences go back and forth.
It starts in E major. And when we get to this B flat major, the polar opposite. We almost died when we learned this B flat. But luckily we have solfa. Mi do so, ladies, nothing of him. Mi do so, and. The B flat. Beautiful.
My very first encounter with the Kodály pedagogy happened at Indiana University with Betsy Mall and Jean Sinor. I had my master's degree in the ORF approach, and my students and I were having a wonderful time, but I wasn't sure what did they really know. But when I finished that course, I knew exactly how I was going to teach. So that summer was a life-changing experience for me. Then I started going to courses at the Kodály Center of America, and then my life was again changed because Denise Bacon developed that program, and it was her thinking that it was very important to have a balance of Hungarian master teachers with American master teachers. And so I started working with Hungarian master teachers, and I couldn't believe how I myself, at age 40, could be developing my own musicianship further than it had been at the university. And I thought, my goodness, if I can do that at this age, imagine what young students would be able to do.
When I was too old to be competing as a pianist, I went back to school and received a doctorate in music education. At that time, I had another wonderful Hungarian teacher, Kodály-concept Pianis Daniel. She was one of the first pioneers in North America. And at this school, for 10 years, she field tested her American adaptation to the Hungarian model that was established by Jenő Ádám. So Katinka, developing her curriculum in the 1960s, was able to establish probably the first full Hungarian model curriculum in an American school using American materials. Katinka looked around her and saw Hispanic children and Asian children and Black children and Native American children. And so she included those materials also in her curriculum. When Kodály came several times, Ádám came several times to visit, they would visit the school, they reviewed her curriculum.
My first encounter with the Kodály concept was a very exciting one. It was at the Hart School of Music in Hartford, Connecticut, and the instructor was Clara Nimish. She did something very simplistic. She sang Liza Jane, and she moved her arms as a pendulum on a grandfather's clock. And immediately, I saw it. Bingo! This is the way children can learn to sense the concept of beat and pulse. I was sold. And so from the classroom situation, we move into sacred music, rounds and canons, music of Zoltán Kodály, the bitsenias are used, the 333s are used, basically, because they're coming from that oral tradition. Oh, and we live in America. We have to approach blues and jazz, musical theater for the children.
When your partner sing again.
I think folk music absolutely has a message for everyone because it's the soul. Who can say no? I don't want any soul. You know, it's the message of the people. It's interesting because in today's society, I'm now teaching freshmen musicians, and they are coming with very little social skill. And the first thing I do is have them form a circle, and we start playing games, and they're like, I said, oh, but this is what we do. And they look at me so strangely, but in a couple of months, they're, can we play that game? Because it speaks to them. Somehow they know that they're experiencing something beautiful.
Sally's got a house in Baltimore, in Baltimore, in Baltimore. Sally's got a house in Baltimore, hands full of chicken pie. Kumo for me, kumo for me, kumo for me, kumo for me. Oh, I've got a house in Baltimore, Baltimore, in Baltimore. I've got a house in Baltimore, hands full of chicken pie.
Unfortunately, we have many challenges. We are competing for money with foreign languages study, which is very important, with computers and technology, which is very important, but there's no time for the arts. So we have to continually justify that the arts are doing so much for the child in their soul and in their intellectual development, in their brain development, in every aspect of their life.
Actually, a boyfriend gave me the selected writings of Zoltán Kodály as a Christmas present in 1973, and I could not stop reading it. I was so moved, and I thought, this makes more sense than anything I've ever read. And so my studies with Kati Foraj, I am who I am today because of Kati, and Sabo Helga was where I studied the elementary methods. She is such a fine woman, an excellent pedagogue and musician. I really so enjoyed watching her teach.
When I was just out of college, I went to the Kodály Center of America for my first summer course the summer I graduated as an undergraduate, and I got to work with Kati Komlosh and Peter Erde and Eva Vendre and some wonderful teachers. And as a young musician, the depth of their knowledge and the challenge that they presented to me was incredible.
It's just such a different experience. You hear about Hungary, you hear about the culture and the music and how the music and the culture are connected. And I've seen the manifestation of that work here in America, but there's nothing that can compare to seeing it in its original home in Hungary. So going and seeing where the music was born, where the method was born, and the ideas are still alive, that was a really special experience for me.
I loved the experience in Kecskemét. It took me 6 months following this past summer to stop hearing Peter's voice in my ear, thinking about conducting and thinking about choral work with my students, to finally integrate that into my brain. And to be able to take Hungary back with me was terrific.
Matt, sorry, yeah. did you hear the first note? Wait a little bit before you come down on the beat, and that will act as a little vacuum to and then gentle entrance.
Okay. Let's see if I can do that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, good. I think you can.
Yes. Yes. Good. And ladies, if it helps too, if it helps, you can find your air at that time as well. And there
of
we
course.
Go. Ooh,
of course.
Nice.
Are you happy? Yes.
Yes.
Good.
Nem elég jó pofának lenni az énekórán, hanem komolyan, mélyen és az érzelmekre hatóan is meg kell tudni közelíteni a zeneművet. Szakmai oldalról, tehát a zene miben létét tekintve, a zene elemeit tekintve, a zene elemzését tekintve is, de ugyanakkor annak az emberi életre, az emberi érzelmekre való hatását. Hiszen tudjuk, hogy a kodályi zenei nevelés legfontosabb célja az, hogy a zenét mint egy eszközt használjuk arra, hogy az emberi létünk kiteljesedésében segítsen, hogy jobb emberek lehessünk általa. Az alapvető elméleti fogalmakat feltétlenül meg kell őrizni, vagyis hogy mit tanítsak, mikor tanítsam és hogyan tanítsam, vagyis hogy kezdve a zenei anyanyelvtől a kottaolvasás ismeretén át a zeneművészet legszebb elemeiig, hogy az életkornak megfelelően, és hogy mindig az éneklésen és a személyes tapasztalaton keresztül. Ezek olyan alapfogalmak, amelyeken nem szabad változtatni.
Kecskemét, I saw that there was a tremendous emphasis in choral music, and that's what I wanted, so I registered for the course, and it was the summer of 91, and then in the fall of 91, I was a registered student at the Kodály Institute, because I was so taken by the course, by what they were doing, by all the philosophy behind the music teaching, the beauty of the singing and the beauty of the conducting, and so that made my decision. Probably the most rewarding aspect of working with children is the fact that you're working with honesty. Children are the most honest people. They are also, in some ways, they don't have any limits because no one has told them yet what their limits are. If you show these children true beauty, they will embrace it with their whole being, and it will be an honest embrace. That and seeing all of these light bulbs, the eyes opening, when you just open a door for them and you show them what's behind that door, and what's behind that door is a beautiful chord or a beautiful melody or a beautiful sequence, and then to see that revelation in their eyes, that to me is priceless.
Tanárság az ma már nem pedagógiai tudomány, hanem igenis művészet. Én azt tanultam a Kodály intézetben, a tapasztaltabb kollégáimtól, hogy minden órán ugyanúgy égnek, mintha egy koncerten a Carnegie Hallban vezényelnének. És szerintem, hogyha ezt valahogyan meg tudjuk tanítani, meg tudjuk tanulni mi magunk, hogy amikor oktatunk, akkor művészetet csinálunk, akkor szerintem mindegyik énekóra hasznos lehet, és mindegyik óra elérheti a célját. És hogyha mindegyik énekóra elérni a célját, akkor biztosan boldogabb emberek lennénk. A lényegét érintetlenül kell hagyni a Kodály-módszernek, illetve a tanításunk gyakorlatának, hogy igenis az énekléssel, az éneklő fiatalok lesznek egy érzelmileg és értelmileg is tisztább jövőnek a letéteményesei, hogy énekléssel kell megszújtani őket. Hogy hogyan? Na, ez biztosan nagy kérdés, és hogyha minden tanár megtalálja azt a repertoárt, amit ő tényleg szívvel, lélekkel tud tanítani, és örömmel, és esetleg még zenei színvonal is be tudja mutatni a hangszerével vagy énekelve, akkor minden iskola éneklő iskolává válhat.
Azért tanítunk zenét, mert a zene az jó. És zene nélkül nem lehet élni. Ez tényleg egy ilyen mindennapi betevő. Az, hogy ez a klasszikus zene hogyan érkezik hozzánk, hogy ez most mozgáson keresztül, vagy hangszeres tanításon keresztül, vagy éneklésen, az tulajdonképpen teljesen mindegy, az a lényeg, hogy valahogy megérintsen belülről, hogy mindent, ami benned van, vagy amilyen hatások érnek, az ki tud magadból adni valahogy.
Mindenütt az volt a tapasztalatom, hogy bár adódtak olyan zenetanárok, akik soha nem hallottak a Kodály-módszerről, de ha ők képzett zenészek voltak, akkor ez nekik semmilyen gondot nem okozott. A gond mindig ott adódott, amikor valaki csak a külső dolgokat szerette volna átvenni, úgy, mint kézjelek, meg ritmuskártyák, tehát amik ugye az első pillanatban a szemet megfogják, de igazából semmi köze a zenéhez.
Nem a tititá és a szómi a Kodály filozófia, hanem abból a szómiből nagyon jól meg lehet tanítani Luciano Bériót vagy Karlheinz Stockhausent, mert ugyanazt a szómit váltogatva, ismételgetve a legbonyolultabb 24 szólamú műveket is el lehet énekelni a már nem tonális világban.
Kodály módszer a zenei intelligenciát és analízist is fejleszti egészen kicsi kortól. Teljesen természetessé válik bennünk, hogy hallunk egy zenét és értelmezzük. De nem csak az, hogy most akkor do mi szó, tehát hogy milyen távolságra vannak egymástól a hangok és mi a ritmus, hanem nagyobb átfogó értelmét, a formát, a jelentését, a stílust.
Kodály-koncepciónak, hogyha szorosan véve zenei vonatkozását nézem, akkor a legelső az, hogy belső hallásnevelése, tehát hallásfejlesztés és belső hallásfejlesztése. Neki az volt az elképzelése, hogy az ember úgy olvassa a kodát, mint ahogyha a szöveget olvasna. Én a gyerekeknek azt szoktam mondani, hogy két funkciója van a hallásnak, belső hallásnak. Egyrészt, hogyha valaki hangszeres és kezébe fogja a kottát, akkor legyen valami első elképzelése arról, hogy mit is akar ő ezzel kezdeni. A másik funkciója pedig egy kontrollfunkció, hogy tényleg azt szólal-e meg a keze alatt, amit ő előzőleg elképzelt.
Írországban is bőven 100 fölötti már a Kecskeméti Kodály Intézetben végzett karnagyok és zenepedagógusok száma. Közülük sokan az ír kórus élet meghatározó művészei, illetve az egyetemi szintű zenész és zenetanárképzés vezető oktatói lettek.
We are here in the DCU All Hallows campus in Dublin, the Dublin City University. And Ireland has a remarkable connection with the Kodály Institute. For such a small country, we really have many, many people who have travelled from Ireland to Hungary at various stages of their careers and of their musical activities to learn from the Hungarian teachers, from the wonderful way that they work.
And the next one will be jumping with this one.
I think both Ireland and Hungary have very rich musical heritages, and it's something maybe we don't even think too hard about. It's inherent in us as a people, and it's embedded in our national psyche that we are a musical nation, and that alone, regardless of the fantastic Kodály concept that we are now learning about, that connects the Irish people to the Hungarian people.
What Holly and I experienced in Hungary, what you guys through Róthin, who was in Hungary, have now experienced secondhand, it's a continuing cycle, and it's spreading. It's like a disease, a good disease.
My whole 4 years in college, I'm still studying at the moment, but have been influenced by Kodály, and even now the way I've learned music through Róthin is the way that I now teach music to younger children now. So it's just amazing. And I feel like when we were learning in college, it really got that idea of music being for everyone regardless. So I had never had any experience, but I was still able to learn all these new amazing techniques.
I found on my first day of college, it was a real experience when Róthin started singing to us. I had my pencil in my hand and paper in front of me ready to start writing notes, but it was more put the pen down and get involved. It was like the workshop we had, this energy, and you felt like it was a workout, you know.
It was a workout.
And, yeah, and I think it's more memorable that way. You really learn a lot more when you're actually up and doing it, moving around and, you know, making the gestures, rhythms, and in singing all at the same time. And I feel that's the memorable thing. And I think that's what I'd like to bring now as my first year as a teacher. That's what I want to bring to my students. And I find it's something that can be brought for everyone, regardless of someone who has been learning music since they were 3 years of age and someone who hasn't studied music at all. Everyone can, you know, engage with that. And I think that's what's really, really good about the Kodály method, yeah.
And everybody loves to sing. Yeah. Everybody loves to sing. And even if they initially don't sing, it's not because they don't want to. It's because they've been told or think that they're not good at singing.
Yeah.
And like, for example, yes, for like, yeah. I have a, it's exciting to go to Hungary, but it's even more exciting to come back and have this secret tool in your pocket.
I was very lucky to have the opportunity of spending 2 years at the Institute. So when I came back, my teaching was completely different, and I changed the way I was thinking and changed the way I taught, and suddenly my classrooms were active. Children didn't sit in the desks. They were up, they were moving, they were singing, they were doing rhythms, they were performing, which I really hadn't done beforehand. So it changed who I was as a teacher, and subsequently it changed my career.
My studies in Hungary inform everything I do, from my own teaching, which would involve, for example, teaching conducting, teaching aural training, teaching keyboard techniques. If I'm teaching somebody to play an alto clef, I'm going to ask them to sing the letter names as well as play them. If I'm teaching analysis, just like all you brilliant Hungarians do, I teach it through through the music, singing, performing the music, listening to it, trying to sing along with melodies, and trying to sing the harmonies, understanding the harmonies.
Kodály's basic tenet that music is for everyone is so easily adaptable to the world of singing in a choir. And this is so wonderful because it doesn't matter what level the singer is at, and anybody can be involved in a choir. So from the youngest age, from the least experienced singers to the most experienced singers. And this is, I think, the wonderful united message of the Kodály-concept.
Hollandiában a Hágai Királyi Zeneakadémia évek óta fontos partnere a Kodály Intézetnek. A Zeneakadémián keresztül kezdődött meg a közös munka a világhírű holland nemzeti ifjúsági kórusokkal is.
With five of my colleagues, I visited the course in Manchester. And this was very surprising to us because we were music theory teachers, all of us. So we thought we had quite advanced skills. And we met a Hungarian teacher there. She was our solfège teacher. And we had to do so many new ways of handling the material. And this was very interesting for us because immediately we knew that it is a way of teaching that maybe starts for children, but you can take it all the way up to the highest level of conservatoire teaching. So this was a very good introduction, I think. In the conservatoire, we felt the need in the theory department that we should make a change. And in 2012, we decided to invite Mr. Laszlo Nemes to work for 1 week with our music theory teachers. And what happened was that we were suddenly students again ourselves because the way of working was so different. We still had our skills and we know a lot of music, but the approach was new and we could feel how it was to learn. And this made a change in the thinking of the theory teachers.
I started a children's choir in a small village where I live, and all the children were welcome to sing. But we had also some monotones, so that you can. That means that you cannot sing a melody, but you sing a twinkle, twinkle, da da da. So you have no awareness of that. So when we started with a relative solfa, I discovered that it was so helpful in a short time. So some children, after 1 year or 2 years, they sang solo. We use it for all the music, also when we sing Schönberg or Hans Werner Henze. We use it because the interesting thing is that the singers, they learn the language. It's a musical language, and the relative solmization and also rhythm language, it helps them to really to understand what are we doing. So it gives you the opportunity to sing in a more musical way without explaining it. So it is a tool to be more independent.
Where was it?
The last part.
Exactly. So could we start there and really connect with the sound of the middle voice?
Kijk allemaal naar de kerk en zing daar.
We got the idea to involve one of the ex-members, that's Irene, and she has a very good hearing for what is a healthy use of the voice, but and also what is your voice, and what is your voice, and what is your voice.
Started the international department in 1986, and one of the things that was really key to us was having music, art, and gym as specialised subjects. So we make that an important part of our offering in school, and we see that for international children, this is a really great lesson for them to be involved in their education. Sometimes they arrive with no English, and music lessons and art lessons are often the first lesson where they feel most comfortable and at home in the school because they can express themselves, they learn their English very well, and they really feel part of the class. The community of the singing is fantastic.
Mother is singing lullaby.
One and two and off we go. Ole, my ole, this is...
The most valuable thing about the Kodály concept for me is the singing and the active music making. So the children are a part of the music, and that makes them individual musicians.
Good night to you all. May your dreams be sweet. May silence surround you, your slumber be deep. Good night, good night.
Because of my international classes, I use specifically English songs, and I chose for more the British and American folk songs. But because I am Dutch, I love to bring my own folk music, and because we're in Holland, to the children as well.
Bells in the steeple, so loudly they ring. This is a holiday, ding, ding, dong, ding.
When I design a lesson or even a curriculum plan, I have a couple of focuses that I have sort of at the same time. I want to improve their reading and their writing and their understanding of the music, but I also want to give them as much music as possible and as much of the feeling and the emotional side and the social aspects of everything that is there. So the togetherness of it is very important for me.
She has a sweet voice. She sings very nicely. She's very sweet. She likes children, and that's a good thing, that if she likes children, she's really nice with the children. She enjoys singing, and because she enjoys, we enjoy. Wink an segle forüten wind, wink an ruten orar, wink an skiljes from vanen min, utas vela torar.
I was going to send my child to any kind of music lesson that there was, but I was happy that it was some sort of interactive music lesson as well, because he's very playful, and so anything that's being taught to him in a playful way, he will accept naturally. So this is how I got to in touch with Kodály, only through the teacher.
The school gives me the opportunity to teach
twice a week and also teach according to Kodály-concept is because I started 4 years ago and then there was no singing culture at this school. It was really, the older children had a lot of troubles with singing and moving and they were ashamed and it was not normal. I think the director and the parents saw over the last year the joy was growing and they saw the children can be independent musicians and they enjoy this process of learning and it's not a torture but a joy, as Kodály said himself.
Az angol Kodály mozgalom lelke a British Kodály Academy évtizedek óta magyar és angol mestertanárok közreműködésével dolgozik a brit zeneoktatás fejlesztésén.
The British Kodály Academy exists to help people on their journey to develop their musicianship, their own personal journey, but also very much in mind we have music education, which means we help a great many teachers. This came about because Yehudi Menuhin very much wanted to help and improve music education over here, and he asked Kodály to recommend someone. Cecilia Voideck came to the UK in 1967, and she devoted the next 43 years of her life over here in the UK, talking, lecturing, presenting the Kodály message. To music educators.
The person who'd been running the course said, we're very lucky, we have Cecilia Voider, who is a pupil of Kodály's, is going to come next week. She's going to do 6 Monday afternoons. So I signed up for that course, and that was the beginning. And I was just hooked, as I said, immediately. It was because it just, yes, it woke something up in me, which had been dormant. And I remember the very first time that we sang Sa Mi Do. I remember thinking, oh, that's what a major triad is. And it was like all these sort of bits of information that I'd half understood or not understood. Suddenly it all started to make sense.
Rocky Mountain, Rocky Mountain, Rocky Mountain High.
Anglia vezető zenei intézménye, a Guildhall School of Music and Drama szintén a Kodály módszert használja a fiatal tehetségek zenei hallás fejlesztésében.
One of the greatest joys for me is seeing the children who are so happy. They are so engaged with what they're doing, and because they're getting this musical input from so many different ways, very rounded musicians are created as a result. I've always felt learning the songs and the games and the activities, that's the easy part. The hard part is how do I put it all together? And I think that's one of the biggest things that we can do as teachers, is to create musically independent pupils of whatever age.
This is Frances, my daughter. She's 9 years old and she's been attending Guildhall School of Music and Drama kindergarten course since she was 4 and a half, and now she's here at the string training program.
In Kodály lessons, I quite like Ickel Ockel and Rain Is Falling Down.
Rain is falling down. Pitter-patter, pitter-patter, rain is falling down.
Do it together again.
And? Rain is falling down.
Good.
Rain is falling down. Rain is falling down.
Don't rush.
A Pekingi Zeneakadémián Tianqing Gao professzor vezetésével került kidolgozásra az új zenepedagógiai rendszer, amelynek alapja a 3 nagy európai zenepedagógiai örökség, a Dark Rose, a Kodály és az Orff módszer.
就想通过对科大一体系的引进和学习啊，我们对中国的学校英语教育进行一个改革。首先就是科大一的教育理念，让音乐属于每一个人，这个是非常鼓舞我们的。因此，我们提出了让音乐属于每一个中国人的口号，就是第一个呢，也是非常重要的。科大一认为，音乐教育是每一个孩子都应该享有的权利。
你这个你就可以照前，照这个上面我翻好了。
屋檐下有一只鸟巢住着呀，燕一家。屋檐下有一只鸟巢住着呀，燕一家。好像不那么清楚，弄短一点好吗？而好的音乐教育是孩子们的一个精神享受，而且我记得科大一还说过，像他。 讲了一个很好的一个老师，像他那么样的好的老师，现在就在匈牙利都是像蓝宝石一样的珍贵，就特别少。科大一认为呢，孩子们学英语的最好的方法就是通过实践。
不好听，今天声音不好听，我听一听是谁故意在那儿捣乱呢？
我来这儿仔细听啊，再来一次，我们来唱一个上行的音阶，哆开始哆。第四个就是，科大一认为人声是最好的工具，就人的声音是最好的工具，那么，其实这个来说，对于中国人来说是特别适合的。 那么，所以这个四个音乐素养呢，第一个就是自主音乐需要，这个自主音乐需要，它是一个积极的自主音乐需要。然后第二个呢，它是实践能力，音乐实践能力。第三个呢，是一个优质的情感体验，学生要有一个音乐情感体验。第四个就是他全面的音文化理解，这个是我们。
Részről először Szirányi Borbála tanított Pekingben, akit számos kiváló intézeti tanár követett, és egyre több pekingi zeneakadémista érkezett Kecskemétre. Igen fontos eredménye a két intézmény együttműködésének Kis Katalin tanárnő Kínára adaptált tananyagainak megjelentetése.
A tankönyveimmel egy olyan repertoárt adtam a kezükbe, ami alapján a kezdők, hogyha csak azt követik, akkor is nagyszerű zenei anyaggal találkoznak, de ha már nem annyira kezdők, akkor válogathatnak hasonló értékeket maguk is. Úgyhogy én inkább a repertoárban hiszek nagyon annak az építő erejében.
A pekingi Kodály.pont az ottani Magyar Kulturális Intézet kezdeményezésére jött létre. Ez egy olyan oktatási központ, ahol a Kodály intézet által delegált tanárok tanítanak, kifejezetten a Kodály.pont számára összeállított tananyag alapján.
Ide a Peking Magyar Kulturális Intézetbe több mint 100 diák jár el minden egyes héten. Több rétegű a tevékenységünk, mert ugye kisgyermekektől kezdve ugye diákokat oktatunk heti 7 napon keresztül, illetve különös hangsúlyt fektetünk arra, hogy az oktatókat is továbbképezzük, tehát hogy ők is megismerjék, belekóstolhassanak a Kodály módszerbe, és hogy azokból különböző technikákat eltanulva alkalmazni tudják azt a mindennapi munkájukban.
A gyerekeknek a jó része már 3 éve a tanítványaimnak mondhatják magukat, és ez a 3 év, ez nagyon sokat számít, ez látszik, és ez hallatszik remélhetőleg az egészen, de nagyon sok az új, tehát majdnem a fele új a gyerekeknek, ennek a 30-35 főnek. Nagyon hamar felveszik a fonalat az idősebbek, vagy akik régebb óta tanulnak, vezetik a kisebbeket, és a kicsik nagyon fogékonyak, és nagyon hamar mindent meg tudnak tanulni. Úgyhogy én nagyon örülök, hogy a kínai gyerekekkel ilyen könnyű dolgozni.
Míg Kínában a 2000-es évek elején indult a Kodály módszer terjedése, Japán az elsők között adaptálta. Köszönhetően Hani Kiokonak, aki a Liszt Ferenc Zeneművészeti Egyetemen tanult az 1950-es években. Hazatérve megalapította a Japán Kodály Intézetet. Tevékenysége nyomán Ruriko Kaze, Tanimoto Kazuyuki, Takao Nakamura és Miyako Furia vált a kodályi eszmék követőjévé. Hatásukra évtizedek óta járnak japán pedagógusok Magyarországra tapasztalatokat gyűjteni. Matsushita kókarnagy, aki többek között Erdei Péternél is tanult, elsősorban a japán kórus kultúra népszerűsítésén dolgozik. Ő Bartók és Kodály kórus műveinek egyik leghitelesebb tolmácsolója Japánban. Kiváló zeneszerző, aki Kodályhoz hasonlóan fontosnak tartja, hogy az oktatásban használatos műveket is komponáljon.
あの、日本の人たちに向けに、その小さな曲集を作りました。エチュードって言うんですけど、それをやることによって、ソルミゼーションとか、それから倍音列のことが学べたり、そして、カノンをやったりとか、それからポリフォニーの勉強したりとか、いろんな曲があるんですよ。100曲あるんですけど。 僕は神様に感謝しているのは、僕が日本に生まれてきたことなんですけど、それは古代とは、ハンガリーとはとっても遠いんですけど、同じペンタトニックの国なんですね。だから非常にアレンジがしやすい、考え方も似ている。ですから、とてもラッキーでした。嬉しいです。
desce, meus senhores, com o vinho da pipa a correr. Assim mal criada, vinhada, que o fado era fada valer.
A 20. Század legnagyobb portugál zeneszerzője, Fernando López Graça, Bartók és Kodály nagy tisztelője volt. Fontosnak tartotta, hogy a kodályi eszmék Portugáliában is elterjedjenek, és személyesen vett részt a Kecskeméti Kodály Intézet megnyitásán.
Van két nyelv, a portugál meg a magyar, mindegyik jó nehéz, és alapjában véve könnyen és jól meg tudjuk egymást érteni a magyar népzenén, a fádún, Viena de Mótán, Kodály Zoltánon keresztül. És az ember talál valakit, aki még mélyen elkötelezett ez iránt, az ügy iránt, ő Cristina Brito da Cruz, nem az egyetlen, de egyértelműen fontos az ő személyében a történetben, és megpróbálja ezt az ügyet támogatni.
A lisszaboni magyar nagykövet 2018-ban a Magyar Érdemkereszt aranyfokozatával tüntette ki Cristina Brito da Cruzt, a Kodály-módszer több évtizedes portugáliai népszerűsítéséért, és aláírták a Portugál Kodály Központ alapításáról szóló dokumentumot.
I truly believe that you should start through singing and moving and feeling. And after being at ease with music, rhythms, melodies, polyphony, then you should start the instrument. So it just made sense at a point. It's Kodály ideas and feeling and knowing what music was about was essential. But it took me over 10 years to start doing Kodály consistently. Yes. They are teachers. They're in their 30s, 40s, 50 years old. And some of them never played these games as children. And you should start like that. Music has to be something natural, something that gives you pleasure. And then you have this need to study an instrument because you want to, not because your father or your mother or your godmother tells you to. It needs to come from within. We have lots and lots of people that collected materials either by recording them or writing down the melodies and the texts. But the problem is they didn't value the music for children. So we don't have much of these titi songs and just, you know, simple rhythms, two, three sounds, because they weren't considered real music. And it's a task Kodály and his students did, starting in the 20s, but going into the 1950s. And we are doing it now in Portugal.
I was on tour with the American Boy Choir, and we were on tour in Texas, and the bus broke down in Paint Rock. We told the mayor, we have a bus broken, and we have 30 boys that are really hungry. Is there anything that you can do? And then he said, yes. He picked up the phone, he called everybody in town, and they each brought tables and food, and they prepared the meal for us. So as a way of saying thank you, we sang for them a little concert. And the first song in the program was Mountain Nights by Kodály, the number one. There was this old man, very rugged. He was a cowboy, you know, with the cowboy hat, the really broken clothes, and a grown beard, and dust all over. And about halfway into the song, he started crying. And you could see the tear coming down because it was gathering dust. And at the end of the concert, he came to me and he said, "I have never heard a sound like that in my life."
Yehudi Menuhin ezt írta 1965-ben. Kodály Zoltán életművével találkozni annyi, mint korunk egyik legkiválóbb zenészét csodálni. Három élő emlékművet hagyott hazájára és az emberiségre. Zeneműveit, Bartókkal együtt végzett kutató munkáját és a gyermekek zenei nevelésének új tanítási módszerét. Mi mindnyájan, azok, akik muzsikálunk, és azok, akik örömüket lelik a muzsikában, végtelen és maradandó hálával tartozunk neki.